You are able to see the content, dear students. Hello, Jivita, Jayashree, Aditya.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, what you can see on the screen? Can you confirm me?
Smart and connected cities.
Okay, pa. Thank you. So second assignment, second quiz. I request all the students to submit it because so today HOD sir is going to check the assignments and quizzes. Those who are not submitted, so you will not be allowed to take the second internals. Keep in mind that. Okay, that is the one instruction, and you know that you have internals on Monday, right? And last whatever the instructions you have received for the last same, you have to write the test and you have to upload it in the MS Teams to the mail and to controller of examinations. Okay, three copies you are supposed to submit. Okay, so go through the instructions, the previous instruction circular, whatever we have given, you just go through that. Okay, and one more very important instruction is, see, yesterday or day before yesterday I shared one circular with respect to the vaccination. Okay, so all the students are requested to get vaccinated before coming to the college. Okay, you may be coming to the college or you may be going to attend the exams, right? So if you have the certificate of vaccination, then only you will be allowed to take the exam or entering into to the college. Okay, so that is very important. So, and I will create on Google form. So by next week you have to upload your certificate. Okay, then only you will be allowed to enter into the college campus. Otherwise, if you are not get vaccinated, right, so no entry. Well, right, I think people have an experience that last when wave one comes, right, so you have to submit the COVID-19 report, right? So RTPC, that report you are
those are second dose, ma'am. Vaccination. Hello? Vaccination should be first dose or second dose?
First dose, those who not got vaccinated, first dose, those who already got first dose, second dose is 84 days, no? Huh? If you are vaccinated, yes. Second dose also, it's well and good, no problem, okay? But you must have the vaccinated certificate that you have to show, then only you'll be allowed to enter into campus. Otherwise, no entry for you people to write the exam or enter into any work related you want to do in the college, will not be allowed. Okay, by next week, okay, I will share on Google form. All the students, you upload your vaccination certificate, okay, whether it is a first dose or second dose, whatever it may be. I think for you people, so you will not get second dose, I think, so no problem. If you have already got second dose also, no problem. Okay, so you show me the any one certificate, no problem. It means you upload by any one certificate. Okay, that is these are the very important instructions I supposed to give. And one more is, those students who are not paid, still paid a single pie of the fees in the eighth semester, they are not allowed to take the test. So I am instructing you people, at least to some amount I asked you to pay. Okay, and few students still they are not turned up only. I don't know why, what is the reason behind that, even they are not contacting me also, right? If any of your friends of such kind, you please instruct and intimate them. Okay, so that is about the recording your internals. Okay, now I'm repeating the topic, fifth module. Okay, if you have any doubts with respect to your test, then we'll discuss it. Otherwise, I'll continue the revision part of the fifth module, that is the last topic, smart city architectures. Any doubts for you with respect to second internals topics or any clarification you need? You have to respond, students. You have any doubts, any clarifications you need? Aishwarya, Aishwarya Lakshmi, Amruta, Anila, Ashta Singh, Priya, Banu Pratap, Bhumika, Chandan, Biji, Chandu, Aindavi, Diksha, Dikshayan, Divya, SD, Mohammad Rafi, G, Rakshita, Gauri Shankar, Harshita, VN, Priyanka, Jayashri. Any clarification you need? Any doubts? Anything you want to share with me with respect to the academics? Any information you want to share? You can. Okay. Now, the next is the smart city architecture. How we are going to connect the smart cities with the fully automated metropolitan cities or any other cities, right? So the in this world, okay, so less than 1/3 of the world's population lived in cities, okay, in 1950s. By 2050, 2/3 of our planet's population will be city dwellers. Africa and Asia, which today account for 90% of the world's rural population, okay, are projected to have 56% and 64% respectively. 56% is Africa and 64% is Asia continent, okay? Of their populations urbanized. Today, the percentage of people in North America, Europe, Latin America and Caribbean who live in the cities already exceeds 70% because they're all developed countries, right? So since they are developed countries, they have already modernized their lifestyle, okay, and they started living in the cities, and all the agricultural land has been converted into the industries, right? So in terms of the raw numbers, the urban population of the world has grown to nearly 4 billion from just 746 million in 1950. By 2050, this figure will grow by another 2.5 billion, not million. See there, 746 million, okay? So it is going up to 2.5 billion. Most of the cities started small urban centers and grew or organically, okay? Very few of them were initially designed to immediately accommodate a very large population. Rapid growth typically strains city infrastructure, road, bridges, and other facilities with the help of the municipal corporations, right, often reach their maximum capacity, making access to the urban services challenging. The question of how to provide basic necessities, amenities to the people who are living in the city, like water, housing, and reducing the carbon dioxide, and to began to dominate the agendas of the city planners and civic leaders everywhere, right? So as the world population grows, emission and consumption all increases because nowadays people, everyone wants a vehicle, okay? So if in a single house, the 4 people are there means 8 vehicles will be there, right? So one is within the city limits, the other one will be to go outside, right? Like that, it is growing, okay? The vehicles population is growing like anything, Okay, when the population concentrates in limited geographic areas, the environment's ability to absorb the emissions and waste becomes a challenge. So you can see, especially you take our Bangalore only. So previously it was named as a garden city. Now it has been named as a garbage city. That is because when no more number of people are started living in the city, okay, and there will be a lot of problems, right? And there will be no cleanliness when the population increases in any city, particularly not only in Bangalore, even in all the metropolitan cities like Chennai. If you go to Chennai, there also is the worst situation when compared to the Bangalore, right? So, okay. And even if you go to Bombay, still it is worst. If you go to Delhi, there also the worst, okay? In Bombay, there is a one street, okay? The only laborers will be there. Around 25 lakhs laborers are there in that particular street. So that is because of that area, right? The COVID-19 has increased because they will not take care, no hygiene maintenance, right? They will not be very, they will not maintain the proper way of leading their life, right? They will not be in the systematic way, okay? They will cleanliness, uncleanliness in their, as in their surroundings. That is the reason why Maharashtra still is in the top in COVID-19 cases, because only of that reason, that because of that area. Okay, around 25 lakhs laborers are living there. Okay, so now that is about the environment ability absorb the emissions and waste becomes a challenge for a sea where there is no place, no one is allowing us to throw our garbage, city garbage, to any area, right? Even nearby villages also they are not allowing, right? So that is what this is a challenge for the any metropolitan cities. The triggers for climate change are exaggerated by increase in emission and waste. Today, cities are responsible for 60% or 80% of world's energy and greenhouse emission, and consume 60% of all potable water, losing as much as 20% in leakage. See, our earth, you know that only in four part, only one part is only the soil, right? The other part is full of water, okay? So here what I can tell you is that, so even though we have such a voluminous water usage, but still only in that 5% of the water we can able to use it. In rest of the water is get polluted, like you take our Ganga river, right? So it is not useful for to use for a human being, right? Because of so many issues, okay? And salt water, ocean, right? And that is because of those reasons, okay? We have only 5 to 10% of the water we can use, whatever the content of that water is in our earth, okay? One key concern of the city leaders around the world is to optimize the resources, that is the water, power, communication, infrastructures, and efficiency, and so on. Waste and emission proceedings, that is the population, pollution we have to decrease in, especially in metropolitan cities, right? However, city leaders also know that increasing population in a city provide an opportunity to capitalize on the city's potential. Within the new population pouring into cities every hour of every day, there are people with skills, talents, and dedicated mentalities that will be asset to whatever the city they end up with living in. The sheer population density will generate more commerce for all the residents. Research from the Institute of Technology predicts that cities in the future will account for nearly 90% of the global population growth, okay, 80% of wealth creation, and 60% of total energy consumption. The goal is not to limit the growth, but to manage population increase more effectively. Improved management efficiency means that providing the better amenities and facilities and the more efficient urban services and ensuring better life experience to the city inhabitants. In short, we can say that economic benefits of large urban populations while mitigating the social and environment difficulties that come with them. Okay, where will the cities of tomorrow find the resource they need to sustain themselves? There are no easy answers, but there are smart solutions. So in this chapter, we are going to cover how these smart solutions are going to be implemented with the latest technologies, with the like IoT networks. And we are going to make the whole city as an automation, right? So these are all the challenges that we are going to face in constructing the smart cities, right? So an IoT strategy for smarter cities is this section, which is going to define how technologies can be leveraged to improve the lives of the citizens and efficient management of the urban centers. Okay, so we need a smart city architecture in order to maintain the automation, right? Which is going to describe the four main layers integration of the IoT for smart cities. That four layers I explained, you know, street layer, city layer, data center layer, and service layer, right? And smart city security architecture, that is also plays very important. So whatever the data is moving in and around of our network, right? This is very important concept, is whether it is a data in terms of KB or MB or GB or TB, right? So we need to provide the security for data, that data which is distributed in the network. Because of the problem is this, any hacker can hack that particular site and disturb the normal way of leading the life, because they want to trouble in one or the other way. So maybe because of their greed, because of their sadism, right? Because of their ill health, right? So there are so many plenty of reasons are there for any hacker to hack a particular site. Okay, so the next is that we have to provide the security for that. So we are going to develop a architecture in such a way that each and every information is going to be secured very well. Okay, and I will give some example, use case examples. Okay, so this smart city IoT for smart city, street lighting, smart parking, traffic, and smart environment, and public safety provide two other use case that apply to smart cities that are being enough to require the dedicated. Okay, now come to the first strategy, that is an IoT strategy for smarter cities. So what is an IoT is going to have the strategy to make any city a smarter with its own way of distributing dispersing the weightage of the IoT strategy. Managing a city bears some resemblance or to managing a corporate enterprises. As the need for efficiency increases, new tools help increase operational efficiency for cities. Just as for business, digitization transforms our perspective on operations. New ideas emerge, bringing different approaches to solving management issues. Scalable solutions utilizing information and communications technology can alleviate many issues urban centers face today by increasing efficiency, which reduces cost and enhances the quality of the life. Cities that take this approach are commonly referred to as a smart cities, urban planning and city policy circles worldwide. So once you are going to make a planning of the city to make it as a smarter, right? So we are going to use some policies and some rules and regulations which are going to be elevated in many issues to the urban centers. Okay, vertical IoT needs for the smart cities, what actually required when you are going to make it as the smarter city. Okay, all our metropolitan cities, which we know that there should be a proper planning of a area, right? And proper planning of the where to locate the industries and where to locate the residential flats, right? There are many differing approaches and solutions for city management. All these solutions typically start at the street level with a sensor that captures the data on everything from parking space availability to water purity. Data analytics is also used extensively, for example, to reduce the crime, to improve the traffic flows. Citizens can use tool to leverage their smart mobile devices such as to report the problems and make the recommendations, right? So means the smartphones what we are using are should be in a position to intimate the information to the concerned authorities. Okay, so cities are expected, that is why we have to use a, say for example, I want to send some information with a video or with a picture form, right? So basic model in mobile is not able to send that kind of information. So for that, what we need some smart mobile phones to improve the urban life or locate available parking spaces. When enabled through the connectivity of the internet, right, the smart solution can have transformative impact on the quality of the life. Information and communication technology, which is going to connect people, data, things and process together in networks of billions or even trillions of connections. So that is the internet facilities plays very, very important role when we are going to come in contact with the smart cities, right? When the create amounts of data, some of which has never been accessible before, when the data is analyzed and used intelligently, the possibility to correlate, analyze and optimize the services and process that is going to deliver the better quality of the life for people are practically endless. Okay. So however, the growth of the IoT application for urban centers not only delivers the unique benefits for each issue it solves, but enhances its ability to develop even the efficient services for any metropolitan city people, right? Even there also should cooperate, and they should also take, it is a each and every person's responsibility to keep the city clean, right? And they have to think it is a public, right? So it is not, it will not come in picture of the individuality. So cities are expected to generate almost 2/3 of IoT overall civilian benefits worldwide over the next decade. To maximize the value, smart cities are combined use cases through a shared revenue business. That is, we are going to collect the money in terms of tax, right? Property tax may be, road tax may be, right? That is all because to improve the quality of the life, right? So, okay, for that is it is a service to the people, and for that they are going to pay in terms of the, in the name of a tax, right? So smart cities can combine use cases through a shared revenue business model together with special patterns to monetize the city local location services for retail and tourism, as well as city planning, parking and water management. Cities are expected to generate almost 2/3 of IoT, as I told. Okay, a recent Cisco study, because why we always use the word Cisco is, that is because Cisco is the only one company that is very popular in its networking area, right? Even see you, I think you people have executed the computer related network experiments with the use of Cisco Tracer packet, right? So now for IoT network also, thus Cisco is taking initiative to on IoT network, expects IoT to do the following economic impact over a 10 years of period. So smart buildings have the potential to save $100 billion by lowering the operating cost of reducing the energy consumption through the efficient integration of the heating, ventilation and air conditioning and other building infrastructure system. Note that financial gain applies to city budgets only when a building is city owned. However, reduced emission benefits the city regardless of who owns the buildings. Then come for the gas monitoring. Okay, monitoring gas would save $69 billion by reducing the meter reading cost and increasing the accuracy of the reading for citizens and municipal agencies, right? The financial benefits is obvious for the users and utility companies when the utility is managed by the particular city with the revenue, what is it going to be generated, right? There are very important advantages in terms of safety, regardless of who operates the utility. In cases of sudden consumption, increased timely alert could lead to emergency response teams being dispatched sooner, thus increasing the safety of the urban environment. Okay, then we need a smart parking system also for any vehicle in the smart city. That is also very important because so smart parking system also plays very important role in the modern world of all the cities, right? So we can could create $41 billion by providing the real time visibility into parking space availability across the city. Residents can identify and reserve the closest available space. Traffic wardens can identify the non compliant usage, and municipality then can introduce a demand based on the pricing. So when you are going to allow the vehicles to park in a particular place, you can collect money from them for on the hourly basis, right? So that is also the revenue is going to be generated through that also when you are going to follow smart parking system, right? So water management is also plays very important role that so proper reading of the there will be no stealing of the water without meters, right? Billions by connecting the household water meters over IP network and provide the remote usage and status information. The benefit is obvious with features such as real-time consumption, visibility and leak detection. In addition, smart meters can be used to coordinate and automate a private and public lawn watering, initiating the watering programs at times when water consumption is lower or in accordance with the water restrictions imposed by the civil authorities, right? As we can see, at a city scale, IoT can be used to manage the water supply equipment and report the status. For example, open or close on or off reservoir level, okay, output speed versus input. A gate or a pump can be opened and closed remotely and automatically in real time based on the variety of the flow input and output analytics data. Vibrations can be measured to detect and predict the potential equipment failures. Repair teams can be dispatched protectively before equipment failure occurs. So that is, prevention is better than cure, right? They have to monitor all the system of water system, whether they wear and all have some damages. They have, before that is going to fail, they have to take some preventive and precautionary measures so that you are going to save the water. These efficiency gains directly translate into the operational gains. And another very important is road pricings, right? As I told, whenever we are going to purchase a vehicle, right, they will put a road tax, right? So for that also you have to pay because we are going to ride our vehicle on the with the usage of the road. So they want to improve the road, okay, by putting tar and all and maintenance of that road also. Cities could create $18 billion in new revenue by implemented automatic payments as vehicles enter busy city zones while improving the overall traffic conditions. Real-time traffic condition data is very valuable and actionable information that can also be used proactively repeated public transportation services and the private users. See, so this who benefits, you just see here. So when MLA enabling the new and more meaningful connections, government and other public sector agencies worldwide can benefit and ultimately create a quantifiable benefits for citizens. Okay, see here. The dark one is as it is, and the which is not shaded will be countries. Cities have the potential to climb almost 2/3 of the non-defense IOE public sector value. Cities will capture much of this value by implementing the killer apps. Okay, see here the color of these. The one which is dark blue is smart buildings. That is a revenue we can generate about $100 billion. And black one is a gas monitoring that we can generate a revenue of $69 billion, right? And light shaded blue is smart parking. We can generate $41 billion from that. Okay, light blue, sky blue is water management. We can generate a revenue of $39 billion, right? And 18 billion will be for road pricing. Okay, so here to maximize the return on investment. Okay, so on their energy and environmental investment, smart cities can employ the strategies that combine a water management, okay, smart grid, waste management, particulate monitoring and gas monitoring. A smart city can use these technological advances to improve its liability index, which can help attract and retain a talent, increasingly competitive labor market. The growth in jobs and talent influences the amount of foreign investment and how many top companies come to settle in the city, which in turn leads to the higher economic impact and improves the potential for new future investments.